station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground, your weekly look at what's happening on board the ISS. I'm Josh Byerly. Orbital Sciences Cygnus completed its mission this week. The cargo craft was detached from the station on Tuesday and sent into a destructive reentry into the atmosphere on Wednesday. This brings to a close the first official cargo flight to the station by Orbital Sciences. So the United States now has two commercial companies, Orbital and SpaceX, flying up to the ISS along with international partner vehicles. It may not be one of the most glorious parts of living on the station, but the crew did do some cleaning this week. Mike Hopkins took some microbial samples from the station's surfaces. This is done to make sure there's nothing gross growing inside. They also change the air filters from time to time to make sure that the air stays clean, because they can't exactly open a window and let some fresh air inside. Did you know that if you were to fly up to the space station, you'd actually get a little bit taller? It sounds good, but it can actually cause some lower back pain. The crew used an ultrasound this week to take a look at their spines. The data will help flight surgeons better understand how the spine expands in space and to help prevent some of that discomfort that comes with it. The crew members took some time this week to talk with the media and a group of students in Los Angeles. They spoke about what they've been up to lately and life on board the station.
We also take a lot of pictures. The cupola has actually fantastic views of the Earth, and so you want to try and capture that and share as much of that as you can.
If you're not following along with the crew on social media, we encourage you to do so. They've been sending down some pretty cool photos of our planet in recent weeks. This week's social media question is, how long can one stay on board ISS? Crews typically stay on board ISS for about 6 months, although astronaut Scott Kelly and cosmonaut Mikhail Kornienko are currently training for a one-year mission that will kick off in March of 2015. The goal of this mission is to learn how the human body reacts to being in space that long and to use that information as we look at going to an asteroid or Mars. And here's some trivia for you. Cosmonaut Valery Polyakov holds the record for the longest single spaceflight. He spent 438 days on board Mir, and the longest trip to the ISS was by Mike Lopez Alegria and Mikhail Turin. They spent 215 days up there. Make sure to keep sending us your questions and comments using the hashtag Space to Ground. We'll see you next week.